Judy Buono Anno, born Judy as Welty, also known as Judy as Goodyear and Judy as Morris, the 4th of April, 1943, was an American convicted murderer who was executed for the 1971 murder of her husband James Goodyear. She was also convicted for the 1980 murder of her son Michael Buono Anno and of the 1983 attempted murder of her boyfriend John Gentry. Buono Anno is also acknowledged to have been responsible for the 1978 death of her boyfriend Bobby Joe Morris in Colorado. However, by the time authorities made the connection between Buono Anno and Morris, she had already been sentenced to death in the state of Florida. Buono Anno is also believed to have been involved in a 1974 murder in Alabama, and in the 1980 death of her boyfriend Gerald Dossett. After her arrest, Dossett's body was exhumed and analyzed for signs of arsenic poisoning. No charges were laid in that case. Buono Anno was the first woman to be executed in Florida since 1848. Judy Welty was married to James Goodyear, born the 7th of December, 1933. A sergeant in the U.S. Air Force, when he died on the 16th of September, 1971. His death was initially believed to be due to natural causes. In 1973, she moved in with Bobby Joe Morris, born 1939. Later that year, she legally changed her name to Buono Anno. Corrupted Spanish for Goodyear. In 1979, Buono Anno's son Michael, the 30th of March 1961, the 13th of May 1980, became severely ill, with symptoms including paraplegia. On the 13th of May 1980, Buono Anno took Michael out in a canoe. The canoe rolled, and Michael, weighed down by his arm and leg braces, drowned. In 1983, Buono Anno was in a relationship with John Gentry. Gentry was severely injured when his car exploded. While he was recovering from his injuries, police began to find several discrepancies in Buono Anno's background. Further investigation revealed that, in November 1982, she had begun telling her friends that Gentry was suffering from a terminal illness. Vitamin pills which Buono Anno had been giving Gentry contained arsenic and formaldehyde. Exhumations of Michael Goodyear, James Goodyear, and Bobby Joe Morris showed that all had died of arsenic poisoning. Buono Anno received substantial life insurance after each death. In 1984, Buono Anno was convicted for the murder of Michael and the attempted murder of Gentry. In 1985, she was convicted of the murder of James Goodyear. She received a 12-year sentence for the Gentry case, a life sentence for the Michael Buono Anno case, and a death sentence for the James Goodyear case. She was convicted of multiple counts of grand theft, for insurance fraud, and is thought to have committed multiple acts of arson, again, for purposes of insurance fraud. All executions in Florida are carried out at the state penitentiary at Stark, and prior to 2000 all were carried out by electrocution in the state's 75-year-old electric chair. A total of 240 men and one woman have been put to death in the three-legged chair, which was built by inmates in 1923. It was rebuilt in 1999 for the execution of Alan Lee Tiny Davis, who was considered to be too heavy for the old chair. Judy's last appeal was turned down on the 29th of March, 1998, and the then state governor Lawton Chiles duly signed her death warrant. She was transferred to Stark and confined to a 12-by-7-foot cell, where she passed her time watching a small black and white television through the bars in the death watch area adjacent to the execution room. Judy spent her final hours seeing her adult children, Kim Hawkins and James Goodyear, other relatives and her legal and religious advisors. Jeannie Eaton, a cousin who visited before the execution, was quoted as saying afterwards she had no fear at all, she's mostly afraid of leaving her children and how upset they were. In a television interview a few days before the execution, Judy said, "I would like to clear the record for my grandson. I would like for him to know that his grandmother was not a murderer." Execution was set for 7 a.m. on the Monday, the 30th of March, 1998. At 4:30 a.m. she was showered and dressed, probably by female corrections, and her head shaved to give good electrical conductivity and so that her hair did not catch fire during the electrocution. Her final meal consisted of broccoli, asparagus, strawberries and hot tea. Judy entered the execution chamber at 7:02 a.m. accompanied by several guards. She was strapped into the large oak chair with 8 leather straps over her waist, wrists, chest and legs. The calf and headpiece electrodes were fitted, each containing moistened sponge to reduce burning of the flesh. Asked if she had a final statement, she replied, "No, sir," squeezing her eyes shut and keeping them shut, not looking at the witnesses on the other side of a glass partition. A leather mask was placed over her face, and at the signal from the warden the automatic electrocution cycle commenced at 7:08 a.m. A small amount of white smoke, or steam, was seen to curl up from her right leg throughout the 38-second cycle, but there were no flames. She was pronounced dead at 7:13 a.m. In an interview afterwards, prison spokesman Jean Morris said, "She was very solemn. This is the first time I've seen that expression on her," he said. She stared straight ahead, made no visible expression. Judy's was the third of a series of 4 executions carried out in Florida over the period the 23rd of March, 1998 to the 31st of March, 1998. Her body was cremated. Thank you for watching, Death Row. Please like and subscribe.